Monday with a little preview on what's going to happen today in Europe. We started last night, cable gapped open on some Times article saying that Theresa May had come to some sort of deal with Europe, and that there's going to be concession from Brussels to keep all of Britain within the customs union, no hard border, etc., etc., etc. Later on in the evening, as in pretty standard practice, this was all denied. The competing paper, The Telegraph, came out saying this is all horseshit. So here's cable. It still hasn't closed the gap. 129.86, 84 has been the low, 65, 130.65 has been the high, 100 points from the close. It looks like they're inching towards a deal. Incredibly difficult to trade, as always, with all of these news and denials and ups and downs, and so gun to my head, I'm long cable. We got long last night at 30. We just cut it at break even because we don't trust this, so we're square at the moment, but looks like this Brexit deal is going to get done, and looks like it's going to get done in the next 30 days, and looks like Brexit's going to be basically not Brexit, as in nothing much is going to change, and this whole charade is all for nothing, just political horseshit. Anyway, moving on, equities are lower in Asia, S&Ps are down just 0.25%, but Nikkei is down 9%, 1.3%. MSCI ex Japan down 1.3, WTI is down 0.75%, so it's a bit of risk off here that's kind of crept in. It hasn't really done much for currencies. We're in a holding pattern here. We had a higher high in euro dollar, we had a higher high, higher low, but we had a sort of close below the open, so it's kind of a bearish looking bar, but this to me, euro still looks like it's turned. I see support here at 113.60 today. Aussie, same type of chart. Put in a hammer on Friday, kind of bearish, but we're going to see support down here at 71.20. Aussie also looks like it's turned. Of course, it's really hard to marry anything here or really put your chips in the center of the table here, because we have the elections tomorrow. Expectation is the Senate stays Republican, the House goes Democratic, which creates basically sort of a standstill as far as legal changes go, as far as any kind of progressive politics comes to an end, because the Democrats will just block everything and the Republicans will block everything from the Democrats, and so we'll just sort of be at a standstill, which I don't know, and for me that's probably not a bad thing considering the zany leadership that we have, but point is no one really knows how this is going to come out, so we have to watch this very closely. Obviously, if the Democrats get both House and Senate, there will be probably impeachment proceedings, which again, I'm not sure what that means, because I don't think he'll get impeached. The proceedings may decide that we're going to vote for impeachment, but then after the vote for impeachment, there has to be a large number of the Senate with this, confirm it. So it's all a bit tricky. Lots of news coming out. We've got RBA, we've got RBNZ, we got FOMC this week. Today we have UK services which is a very important economic indicator out of the UK. And equities, currencies are really just kind of doing nothing. So CAD's on its highs, had a lower than expected employment numbers. No big deal. We think this on the day also is a sell rally. You can sell this up in the 130-130s. I will bring you to one interesting chart if we go risk on Kiwi Yen. It's been much talked about by all the banks, and a few of the hedge fund research guys that we talked to. We have a quadruple bottom here. We have this neckline. It broke briefly on Friday, which is fine. Took out a few of the break traders there, but if you see risk on and you see Aussie moving higher again and dollar CAD lower and commodities moving up and stocks moving up, this is your proxy. You know, if this does go and it breaks, it's probably worth kind of like 300 points. You know, we're looking for a move up to 78. So keep an eye on this. Kiwi Yen obviously is super tricky. Spreads suck. Liquidity is awful. But 75.60 is worth a look. Kiwi Yen, if we turn risk on. I have no idea what would make us turn risk on because I'm pretty bearish and pretty risk off. But if we go risk on, this could be your worst. What else is out there? Not too much, really. You know, we're gonna be forced to keep it light and incredibly tactical because we have all these events on the horizon. The main event is the elections tomorrow, but also I guess tomorrow morning before the elections, the RBA rate statement. Although we're expecting no change, you want to look at that statement closely. The risk with the RBA is they're more hawkish than the market thinks. I don't know why they would be, but everyone's leaning one way here. So if they are hawkish, we will get a boost in the Aussie. That comes out tonight, some ungodly hour in Europe, like 3:30, 4:30 in the morning. So we won't be trading it. But for those of you in North America and in Asia, you should watch that pretty closely, and that's usually a tradable announcement. One other thing today, we've got the Bank of Canada governor is speaking what time is he speaking? He's speaking at kind of around noontime. 2:10 p.m. Central European time today. So you got to watch out for that as well. Bank of Canada bullets speaking just after 2 p.m. European time. So if you've got some CAD on, make sure you tune into that speech. All right. Like I said, not too much to sink our teeth into this morning. We will be very tactical. We will just start to grab cash as it presents itself. Try and build up the kitty so then we can take a few big swings during these events this week. I wish you guys all luck.